As we get started to use this MOOSOO for a whole house cleaning with weighed results, we need to weigh the bin such as it is, and this is about the best way to measure it as a whole. But I did remove the battery. So I'm going to start out with 1,003.6 grams empty everything weight. And like I've done so many times before, I'm going to limit everything to 1,000 square feet, and I'm going to run it in low power and see how long the battery lasts. Away we go. It's not very loud, but I suppose it's not the quietest either, so I'd say on low speed, it's really just kind of in the middle. I would say it's medium heavy in your hand. It's not light, nor is it heavy. One thing I did notice is the nozzle width itself. It's only 8 inches wide, so it's good for cleaning small areas, you know, getting in tight spaces. But for large areas, it's going to take you a bit longer. Well, for those of you that like carpet lines, it makes them, but it's a little hard to see. It's a giant open swath, but doesn't really have a whole lot of aggressive agitation. Thank you. check the grate. Seems to be okay so far. Doesn't hurt the grate, doesn't hurt the vacuum. Open the door. I hope that doesn't fall. Don't fall. Looks like the wheels are a little on the clacky side. Door. Here we go into the green room. We've just gone down to 2 out of 3 lights. Okay, let's take a brief look at what is in the bin so far. Well, it's got something. So here's the other side. See if anything's hiding on the other side. Yep, we got stuff. All right, now we need to go down to the first floor and finish up. Oh yeah, hair pickups so far. So there's some. Not too bad. Fairly typical. Still on 2 out of 3 lights. How long will this last? Well, handles grates just fine. Nothing hits. Sets a spot and rarely gets vacuumed. Okay, time to wheel it into the last two rooms. Oh, good. Handled the bump. How's it do on chair dents? Yeah, a little bit. Yeah. Makes them go away a little bit. Takes a little extra effort. It is easy to push forward and backwards. The handle weight isn't too much. So the light just went down to one bar. We still have power. Well, there's a little look at all the hair pickup. And here's a quick look at what made it into the bin. Definitely see a lot of dog hair, and that screen looks like it's fairly well plugged. So let's take it down to the lab and see what we need to do to weigh this thing and clean it. I'm just dying to find out how this MOOSOO did. Is it in line with the other stickvacs? Make sure that's centered. Okay. And of course I took the battery out. It's back there. I'm going to call it at 1007.3, and then I'll subtract 1003.6, and we end up with 3.7 grams. And I'm going to have to dig in there and figure out a way to try to clean that screen when we do the extracted amount. This might look a little strange because I've never emptied one of these before and, you know, gotten the stuff off the screen. So let's see what happens. Oh, and we can use this nifty little tool to get the hair out of this brush roll because it certainly needs it. So we'll save that for a minute. Change my scale to the more sensitive one. And let's see what happens. How am I going to do this? So that's the easy part. Okay, just kind of push the button and empty what you can. But now we have all of this. Hope you can see that. All right. Now this is where it's going to get messy. Okay, that comes off. This comes out. I can definitely see, yeah, there's definitely stuff in this filter. So I'm not going to count that in the extracted part. Normally I would blow that out anyway. But yeah, I can definitely see this isn't white anymore. And there's stuff in there. If I tap it, it'll come out. But we're not going to actually count that. So I suppose I'll pull off the large chunks. Nothing inside. Now I guess I could also use this to kind of try to scrape it off, I suppose. It works to some degree. Or maybe there's some other, you know, gentle brush you could use. Well, you know, that's working. It's working. You gotta give it a minute. It's working. Well, it takes a little while, I suppose. I think some people probably won't be very happy about doing this every time you use it. Okay, so we have a nice clump so far. So let me take this outer screen off. Oh yeah, we got some stuff underneath it too. This is what we have. I hope you can see that. Yeah, there's stuff that's underneath it. So I'm not sure what you really do with this. I mean, I guess you could move it around a little bit, kind of play with the dirt with your fingers, maybe shake it outside. I don't know, you get inventive on what you want to do with this. So I guess we'll say that's about all I can reasonably extract for the normal person, I suppose. Now, let's collect everything and you put it in the tray here. And you know what? Let me make a little, let me make more room here. Here's my more sensitive scale. Okay, we're zeroed out. So we'll do the fibrous material. You know, it pretty much is almost all fibrous material. There's not much other than fibrous material. I see essentially no dust particles. I don't see anything that's fine. I don't see anything that's medium. I don't see anything that's like large. This is little bits of like, say, sand and grit, and this is dog hair. So we have 2.92, reading this upside down, and you put this in, it's not going to change that much. And it looks like it bumped it up to, I'll call it at 3.10 grams extracted. How about we work on this hair? So this should be a toolless design to remove the brush roll. See, I pulled that little lever back. This comes off. And then this just slides out. Okay, now I get that hair off. And you can just pull it off, but they have this nifty little tool here they've included, and that does have a sharp blade right there in the corner. So let's see how this does. Well, it helps me cut the hair a little bit. Yeah, does a good job of cutting the hair. We do have, good. I can take that end cap off because it's really wound around this part of the brush roll. It's gotten close to that end cap. My wife's hair, if you're new to this channel, is over 2 feet long. And unless you have a brush roll that can mitigate hair wrap, and I have a couple machines that do, this is what I normally have to deal with. I mean, you get used to it. It's not too bad. There's a little bearing right there. Let's see, did I get everything? All right, that should be it. So here's a nice little clump of hair. And then let's put brush roll back together. There's a little accumulation in here. Oh, that's okay. It just blew right out. So that was easy. Of course, now it's on the carpet. But we will take care of that in a minute. So let's see. This has to go, I think, like this. Hooks in and then clicks down. Okay, wonderful. We have some extra juice in this battery. So I'm gonna take the remaining part of this video and just run this machine until the battery actually stops and becomes, you know, completely flat, because I had one bar left when we stopped the test. How much more time is stored in that battery? Let's find out. Here we go.
Okay, the light has now started to blink. So it probably is coming to the end here, maybe in the next minute or so. I can hear the speed decreasing rapidly. The pitch is dropping. Still going. And the pitch is still dropping. And that's it. And when it goes completely flat, there's nothing that blinks right here. It had one blinking light, but it's literally just done, it just goes dark completely when it finishes. That's the end.